Last year, Miami and Cincinnati tangled in the highest scoring shootout ever between these two schools. Redskin quarterback Terry Morris threw for over 300 yards and three touchdowns. But that couldn't outdo the Bearcat tandem of quarterback Dan McCoin and tailback Reggie Taylor. The Bearcat backs amassed almost 650 yards in Cincinnati's 45-38 win. This year has been a different story for both offenses. Miami has failed to find the end zone with quarterback troubles and key injuries. Miami's offense has sputtered while head coach Tim Rose tries to pull the right strings. In Cincinnati, Heisman hopeful Dan McCoin is off to a rocky start. The all-time Bearcat passer hasn't been able to get the UC offense firing on all cylinders. So it's a critical game for both teams as they try to get on track in the 92nd meeting between the Miami Redskins and the Cincinnati Bearcats.
Stadium on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. It's the 92nd meeting between the UC Bearcats and the Miami University Redskins. This is Bob Long along with Greg Christopher. There are some big question marks on offense for both of these two teams in this old rivalry. For the Miami Redskins, Greg, one of the first questions is the health of quarterback Mike Bates.
That's right. Mike suffered a separated shoulder in the Eastern Michigan game. Now, while he played in the Syracuse game, and he's going to play tonight, he's going to be wearing a harness on his left shoulder for the rest of this season. Now, it's not going to affect his throwing any, but it will affect his mobility somewhat.
One constant, though, for the Redskins is the play of wide receiver Andy Schillinger.
Schillinger had 12 touchdown receptions to go along with his 46 total receptions last year. But by no means is Schiller a game breaker. He doesn't have great speed, but he is a great possession receiver.
There are some...
Here we go, Bearcats! Here we go! Everyone down! Here we go, Bearcats! Here we go!
And we are live at Nippert Stadium again as we get ready for the ball game. As the Miami Redskins will be kicking off to start this ball game, the 92nd meeting in 99 years. Next year will mark the 100th anniversary of the beginning of this series, and there'll be a big celebration for that. But not much to celebrate for these two teams so far this season, Greg Christopher. The Redskins enter 1-2. The UC Bearcats also at 1-2. Gary Gusman has the ball teed up here on the Nippert Stadium artificial surface as the Redskins deploy to kick off to Ed Johnson and also Dwayne Hunter for UC. And this 92nd game between these two schools is underway. That's Hunter back at the 5-yard line, got a good lane to the outside and brings it up 6 to the 24-yard line, a return of about 19 yards to start the ball game. And now we'll see Danny McCoin, the troubled quarterback of the Bearcats.
It's going to be interesting to see how McCoin gets off. He's had slow starts against Rutgers and Penn State in the first and third games of the season. So it's going to be critical for him to get off to a good start tonight.
He's had about 380 yards passing in three games, well below his average of last year. We'll be talking more about that as we go into tonight's ball game. Leonard Cry and Alan McKinney are the two backs in the eye as we have the first play from the line of scrimmage at the UC 24. And it's McKinney. Good speed for the running back. He busts that one up to the 31 before Rod Korn comes up to make the stop. It'll be second down and about three as he got 7 on that first carry.
He's running over the right side of that line, which is a huge offensive line. It outweighs the Miami defensive line by 20 pounds.
Actually going to give him 8 yards as he got up to the 32-yard line. So it is second and two. The wide receiver, the man to watch, Roosevelt Mukes. He's got 10 receptions to lead the Bearcats. He is their speed burner. It's the pitch out to McKinney. Not much room that time. He is thrown down behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of about a yard that time. Looked like Andrew Marlette came up there to help make the stop. So it's going to be third and long. Pete Mather was also in there to help break up that play.
Here's the defensive line for Miami. Chris King is a sophomore, but he actually has 4 years of eligibility left. The linebacking crew, Pete Mather is in there starting right now. He's replacing Matt Kahn in the inside. And the defensive secondary is very experienced for the Redskins.
And it's third and three. Possible passing situation here for McCoyne. He's looking deep down the middle, got a man open, and it's caught by Sanders out at the 47-yard line. Rod Corn again on the stop, but McCoyne has his first completion of the night.
That's what Danny McCoyne does best. He gets a good drop back, and he looks for his receiver. Sanders is replacing Joe Heiss, who was last year's leading receiver for UC, and he's an excellent receiver going across the middle. Once again, UC doesn't have a big game receiver. They don't have anybody who's really fast, but Sanders and Heiss are great possession receivers like Schillinger.
First and 10, the first down of this ball game, and it's up to the UC 48-yard line. A 17-yard reception by Sanders. McCoyne faking, rolling, got the screen set up to Leonard Cry. He doesn't catch too many passes, but he gets rumbling down to about the Miami 45-yard line. Tom Fisher, Jerry Prochko came up there on the stop. But another good first down gain, and that, of course, is always important for any offensive team to pick up 7 or 8 yards and set up that second down situation. There you can see McCoyne faking and then turning around. He's got the screen beautifully set up, and it picks up a good gain of about 6 or 7 yards.
A really nice one-handed catch by Cry. He and McKinney were practicing those catches even before the game. Little one-handed passes back and forth from each other.
We'll give it a gain of 6 for Cry. It's second down and 4 at the Miami 46-yard line. We're in the first 2.5 minutes of this ball game. Big pull for McKinney down to the 36. Great blocking up front. Again, Rod Corn had to come up out of the secondary, but not before McKinney got another first down to the 35, a gain of 9 more yards.
Al McKinney has been living in the shadow of Reggie Taylor for the past 2 years. He was an Ohio High School Offensive Back of the Year. He put up some great numbers in high school his senior year. He rushed for 2,398 yards, and get this, Bob, 49 touchdowns in 1 year.
Not something you do usually in college, but possible in the high school ranks. First and 10 at the Miami 35, a good drive so far. Cry has stood up there in the middle, bounces off several people, but he's swarmed under. Fisher was in there on the initial hit, along with a host of other Redskins. Jeff Anderson on the bottom of the pack, also Andrew Marlatt. So Cry didn't get much that time. He went sideways quite a ways there. Cry, again, is the starting fullback. He's had over 100 yards and been averaging about 6 yards per crack so far this season.
He finished last spring as the number one fullback, taking the place of Robert Williams, who started last season but suffered a broken leg in the Virginia Tech game, the first game of the season. So Cry and Tackett have taken over, and they've done a fantastic job.
It's second down now, and some movement in the line, but they get it off. There's a pass incomplete. Looked like somebody jumped, but I guess not. It'll be third down and 9. That's the first incompletion for McCoyne. Corn on the coverage back there. Passes out to Bill Davis, who's also one of the top receivers on this team, along with Roosevelt Mukes.
Davis had his best game ever last year from McCoyne. And McCoyne, as you can see there, holds the Bearcat record for career passing yards. And tonight, sometime, if he gets 149 yards, he's going to break the all-time total yardage record for a Miami player, or for a Cincinnati player, excuse me.
That's for both rushing and passing. So it's third down and 9 now for McCoyne. He's driven his team down to the Miami 34. And he's straight back to pass, got great protection all day, but he overshoots his man, Mukes, out in the flat, and he overshot him by a mile.
He had all day back there. He could have gone back there, set up, taking his time. Mukes was doing the right thing. He was well covered, and he was coming back to the quarterback like they teach a good receiver to do.
So it is going to be fourth down, and right now Gary Overgaw is in there, one of two place kickers. Phil Insolaco's the other, but this one is going to be a try of about 51 yards with it, the 10 yards of the end zone. He's going to punt it instead. He faked the place kick, booms it toward the corner. He might make it. It goes out of bounds, caught by a UC cheerleader, I think, down there. Let's see where they mark the ball. At about the 6-yard line, so a little trickery there. Overgaw is the starting punter, and he fooled Miami on that play. It did look like he might try the 51-yard field goal attempt.
A little variation of the quick kick you might see every once in a while where the quarterback takes it. interesting setup. Keeps the Miami people from having anyone back to get the ball out.
So Overgaw does the job, and he puts Miami in a hole. Ball back at the six. So Miami is in the hole early on. Mike Bates to bring his team up, and we'll see if tonight Miami can get its running game untracked. Right up the middle, John Gist, big hole. Look at him go. Out to the 19, he stumbled and fell, or he might have gone about another 5 or 10 yards. Mike Kelly got him, but a good opening play for the Miami offense. Gist getting a first down.
That's a good omen for the Miami offense. If Gist can get the running game going along with the right side of the line, Schmidt and Gephardt there, they open some huge holes, and Gist gets out, and he's on his own.
You can see, I think he goes down on his own. He does. He does not really get touched. He just fell on his own after a pickup of 12 yards. So a first down for John Gist and the Miami Redskins. Again, it's Gist and some more good yardage. He gets about six more. Art Sheffield made the stop, but Gist running very hard gets the ball out to the 24, and it'll be second down and four.
A nice little draw play there. One thing, here we can see the Miami lineups. Bates is taking over for Terry Morris last year. Gist is a transplanted defensive back. Schillinger, as we said earlier, led the nation in touchdowns last year for receptions.
Bill Jawitz, by the way, alternates quite a bit with John Stofet, one of the wide receivers. They bring in a lot of the plays from Coach Tim Rose. So it's second down and four as Gist got six. And Bates with his first pass zips it to Schillinger. Out to the 40, he's going to break the tackle and go a long way. Finally out of bounds at about the 40-yard line of UC, and a flag is thrown over on the sidelines, and he is knocked down to the track.
Had a late hit, and Schillinger's down, I think. He went down, he got onto the cement there, and he's hurt.
John Lewis was the one that pushed him out, but the flag was thrown down at the 33. Schillinger broke a tackle. He should have been stopped right after about a gain of 16 yards, but instead, it's a huge gainer. Let's watch it again. Bates, good pass. And there Schillinger breaks the tackle. He's going to go down the sideline, and we'll see if we can catch this late hit coming up here. They pushed him after he's already out of bounds. There's 18, giving him a shove over there. And he falls on to the track, and that's going to take the ball even further down into UC territory. He was pushed out at about the 40, and the 15-yard step-off takes it all the way to the UC 25.
It looks like he's okay. I'm sure he'll be back in a game that's as critical as this for the Redskins.
That was a gain of 36 yards on the pass play. Tack on 15 more, so you have a net gain of 51 yards on that play. And with 10 minutes left in the first period, Miami driving in this scoreless duel. Gist and Thomas in the backfield, and this is Thomas, and he will go absolutely nowhere. Chris Asbeck was in there. It's going to be second down and still about 9 yards to go. The first carry of the night for Chris Thomas. We should mention that up front line again of Miami's does a good job of blocking. Matt Kemper, John Schaefer, Sean Riley, Tom Schmidt, and Randy Gebhardt. So Bates facing second down, and we'll call it about 8 yards to go from the UC 23. He's got Schillinger and Stofa flanked this time, and he's looking Stofa's direction. Got him in the corner, caught. At about the 5 yard line, John Lewis again was over there. But Bates is threading the needle.
That was a great pass by Bates. Watch this. It's like a frozen rope on a line to out to Stofa. There we'll see Stofa. He gets right inside Rhodes.
Nice catch down at the 5. They're going to spot it actually at the 6-yard line. So a gain there of 17 yards. And the Redskins are threatening to do what they did last year against UC, and that's take an early lead. Bates down over center, ball at about the 6-yard line this time. This is Gist, got some room down to about the 3 or 4. Stewart in there on the stop that time. So it'll be second and goal. Gist, as we said, has had a mediocre season to start off with 28 rushes for 78 yards coming into this game, an average of less than 3 yards per game, but he's done very well so far tonight. He's already picked up 20 yards in 3 tries. So Miami facing second and goal. They've got the ends in tight now. Let's see what Bates elects to do here if they go wide with the ball. It is Thomas trying to sweep. He's got the corner turned, and he's going to go in. But we do have a flag. We have a flag down in the middle of the field. Hold everything. Let's see who this one goes against. The officials are conferring down there on the field, and we'll see what it is. I don't think it's going to be good news for Miami. They are walking back, and they are no longer celebrating. It is a holding call, what we feared it might be for the Redskins, and that nullifies Chris Thomas's touchdown run. That would have been his first TD carry of the season, but it all goes for naught. Rose cannot be too happy with that play.
I think we're going to see the left side of the line for Miami collapse here, and you're going to see people trying to hold their people back. It looks like the tight end, Steve Fumi, was trying to hold his man back there and got caught for holding.
That moves the ball back, and the Redskins will have it now at about the 10-yard line with second down and goal. 8:49 to go, first period of play. No score between these arch rivals. Schillinger will be in there at one wide receiver this time. They also have two tight ends in there, Mike Kuzan and Glenn Huffman. And Schillinger goes in motion to the top of the screen. Going to pitch it out and go this way with Gist, trying to cut it up inside his blockers. Gets down to about the 3-yard line and out of bounds there. So it's going to be third and goal. Walter Johnson helped to push him out of bounds. Booker also over there on the stop.
That's a nice job by Gist. He got everything he could out of that. That play was extended all the way to the end of the sideline. Last year, as you can see, Gist was a defensive back. He got quite a bit of playing time in the Cincinnati game. He even had 7 tackles. But he shows his quickness there, getting out to the outside, and he did get a couple yards.
He did get the ball down to about the 2-yard line, so that was a gain of 8, and it's third and goal from the 2. The Redskins would like to punch it in for 7 here rather than having to settle for a Gary Gustman field goal. We'll see what Bates elects to do on this third and short. They've gone wide every time so far. This time they're going to go the other direction with Thomas. He turns that corner. He should make it. He is in there for the touchdown, and I don't see a flag this time. So Chris Thomas does end up with his first touchdown of the year.
That's Thomas's first touchdown, and there he shows his versatility. Thomas is playing fullback, but he's got tailback speed. He's got tailback size even. He gets out to the outside. He can just turn on the jets and get into the end zone.
So that comes with 8:37 left in the first period of play. And Gary Gustman will try to extend his string. Now we'll watch the sweep. It goes the other direction. They've been running to the left side. They come back to the right. And again, Thomas waltzing in. So some great blocking up front. Gustman now trying to extend that point string for extra points in a row. And he nails it. So we have timeout down on the field. Our score, the Miami University Redskins 7, the UC Bearcats 0.
The Redskins look like they got their running game going on track, and that's a key tonight because the running game hasn't really done too much so far this year. And the only thing that is really suspect on the Cincinnati defense is probably the front 5. They're missing all 3 linebackers from last season, and their front 4 on the front there, they play a multiple 40 defense. Those people are somewhat new also.
A long march, too, by the Redskins, which is also good news. Any coach loves to see a team march as the Redskins did. They were pinned back, don't forget, all the way at their 5-yard line or 6-yard line and marched it all the way down the field to put those 7 points on the board. So Miami has the early lead here. And we'll see what that does when Danny McCoyne brings his team back out. They ran the ball fairly well in their first series before their drive stalled down at the Miami 35-yard line. Derek Walker, Dwayne Hunter will be back to receive the kick from Gary Gustman, Miami's all-time field goal and extra point leader. Here comes Gustman's boot straight down the field. And again, it'll be Hunter at a 5-yard line. That's where he took the last kick. Out to the sideline, not much room, but he's going to reverse his direction. And he'll be tripped up, a nice shoestring tackle, and he's upset with himself. He thought he could break it, but he just couldn't quite beat the Miami defenders back there. If he would have gotten past one there, he might have been able to go quite a way.
He shows some incredible quickness here, stopping on a dime, turning to his left, and going the other direction. He left a whole bunch of Miami receivers standing right there by themselves.
And they were holding some air when they went to grab for him. So UC starts at its own 21 on its second possession. McCoyne is the quarterback with Cry and McKinney in the backfield. Up the middle, McKinney, huge hole. Breaks it all the way to the 37-yard line. Greg Wersch had to come up to make the stop from the safety spot, but not before McKinney pounded him for 16 more yards, and he's off to a tremendous start. 34 yards on 4 carries already tonight.
I'm really impressed with the offensive line for Cincinnati. They've only got two people back. Irwin Owens, the guard, and Jeff Graham is also back.
So he brought that one out all the way to the 37, first and 10. A 16-yard pickup, and McCoy is back, handing to McKinney again, sweeping the side. Picks up another 8 yards before he smashed out at about the 45-yard line. Jeff Happ was in on that tackle. Pete Mather was also there. That's what we're talking about, a 94-yard drive in 8 plays and helped along by a 15-yard personal foul penalty for shoving Schillinger out of bounds after he was already across the sideline there. So that play got 8 yards. It'll be second down and one, and McKinney is running very, very well against the Redskins so far tonight. Under 7.5 minutes to go in the first period. Redskins on top of UC, 7-0. Miami jumping, flags down, cry is dumped in the backfield, but we'll have to see if Miami was drawn off or if it's encroachment. Andrew Marlatt was in on the stop. UC players are clapping, so we assume it's going to be marked off against the Skins. And that's what it is. Defense jumping across,
hey,
and that will give a first down.
On the concrete.
That'll take the ball up to about the 49, so it's first and 10 from there for the UC Bearcats. So this drive now picking up two first downs as McCoy and company try to answer that Miami scoring drive. This time we have Steve Sanders and Roosevelt Mukes flanked out. It looks like McCoy wants to throw deep. There's the bomb. He's got Mukes out there. Off his fingertips at the 5. Just let him a little bit too much.
Once again, McCoy had all the time in the world back there. His offensive line was giving him great time, and Mukes had beaten the Miami secondary and was open if the pass had been there.
He definitely was out there, and as you say, he has had a lot of time. And so far, though, he's only hit 2 out of 5 passes. His receivers have been fairly well covered. That time, Mukes did have the step, but the throw just a little too long. This time, Joe Heiss is in the ball game along with Bill Davis as they alternate in 2 other wide receivers who are also good receivers. Heiss has led the team in receiving the last 2 years. McCoy straight back again. Lots of protection this time. He's got one man harassing him, and he's going to throw the pass to McKinney in the flat. He will go nowhere. A beautiful tackle over there. Jeff Happ was in on the stop. Also, Sheldon White came up. So that time, they smelled out the screenplay and stopped it right at about the line of scrimmage. He got a very short gain, maybe 1 yard on that one.
The Redskin linebackers read that screen pass very well. They held back. They didn't drop back into their routes completely, and they were able to see McKinney get out there in the flat and go out and beat the offensive lineman and make the tackle.
This time, they'll go with 3 wide receivers, Bill Davis, Roosevelt Mukes, and Steve Sanders on 3rd and long, about 9 from the midfield stripe. Low snap, but McCoy picks it up. Under pressure, gets the pass open to Mukes. He's got it for a first down at the Miami 36. Sheldon White got him. And we have an injured Redskin down on that play, on that coverage. Looked like one of the linebackers.
I think it's Jerry Prochko. He went down when he hit the turf. His arm, when he went down, he hit the turf, and it collapsed right there.
We'll be able to see it
at the end.
Yeah, we'll see if we can see it here on the replay. There you can see McCoy stepping up in the pocket. Right there. Oh, I see what happened. He came in underneath. And that's where he got hurt as he came in to help Sheldon White on the tackle.
I think Sheldon White clipped his right shoulder. Jerry Prochko, the outside linebacker, he's starting along with Tom Fisher on the other side.
And as you can see on the replay, it looked like he came in low. White went over top of him along with the receiver, Mukes.
We're going to watch. Sheldon White's going to clip Prochko's right shoulder.
Right here it comes. You can see him. He got him sort of in the back.
Yeah.
He is coming off the field under his own power. Appears to be favoring that shoulder a little bit, but at least he's coming off by himself, unassisted there. So we'll see how long it takes to get him back in the ballgame. That was a pickup, though, of 14 yards. Coach Tim Rose with a record of 25-22-1 going into tonight's ballgame against the UC Bearcats. His team up in front 7-0. They got off in front of UC last year at Riverfront Stadium. But the UC Bearcats trying to tie it up on this drive. they have shown a lot so far on offense, especially running. And here's McKinney with a gaping hole, breaks it outside, down to the 20, the 18, the 16-yard line. Finally run out of bounds there by Greg Wirsch. But he made another gain of about 20 yards. And unofficially, I have McKinney with 63 yards already in six carries. See it here? The line blocks beautifully up the middle. He turns it to the outside.
The right tackle, Jeff Graham, number 63, made that play for McKinney, the big senior, 280 pounds. Dave Curry called him the best offensive lineman in spring ball, and he's come out this season. He's done a good job blocking for McKinney and Cry.
This drive started back at UC's 21, and it's reached the Miami 16 with first and 10. Here comes McKinney again. The Redskins shut this one down a little better. Pete Mather was over there to mess up that play, and then he got some help. McKinney did not do as well last year, but keep in mind, there was another guy in the backfield last year by the name of Reggie Taylor, who was one of the greatest backs that that the UC Bearcats ever had.
Yardage-wise, he was the best back UC ever had. He was drafted in the 11th round by the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, but is no longer on their roster.
He got about four on that play. It'll be second down and 12. Second down and six, rather, from the 12. Again, Sanders flanked to one side, Davis on the other. Here comes Leonard Cry, the fullback. Breaks one tackle, fumbles the ball, and it's recovered by Jeff Anderson at the 18-yard line. Anderson scrambled out. Mike O'Day was in on the stop initially, but Cry fumbled as he got to about the 11, so the Redskins get a big break.
That's a big break for the Redskins. Anderson comes up with the fumble there, and that's one thing the Redskins haven't been doing this season. They haven't been taking an advantage of other teams' fumbles.
Now let's see whereabouts Cry loses this ball. He's hit right there, breaks that tackle. Rod Corn coming up. Right there, I think it's O'Day who does cause it, and Anderson falls on it. And Miami gets the ball back at the 17-yard line. So the first turnover of the ball game, with 5.5 minutes left in the first period, and Miami guarding a 7-0 lead. Bates back to pass on first down this time. The bomb for Stoffa over his head, incomplete.
Stoffa was wide open down the middle.
Terry Noble was back on the coverage, but it was over his head too. So Bates, that was his first incompletion of the night. He had passed for 53 yards in that first drive. Second down at the 17-yard line for the Redskins.